And
So, actually, before we wrap up, we actually want to ask you from your own experience of talking to so many people and then, doing consultations with so many people, what kind of interesting results have you seen from either bioregulator peptides or just other peptides?
On the bioregulator front, like I said to you before, we talked about the postmenopausal woman who had breakthrough bleeding, but the flip side of that, I've seen cycling women who had lost their cycle for whatever reason, who brought on apitalon and the ovarian bioregulator and restored their cycle, right? So, or it can help with fertility. Not because it makes you more fertile, but if it starts to help to your body to rebalance its hormones, then all of a sudden, and they're still doing all the other work, let's not forget, they're doing all the other things, they're managing their stress, they may be also using adrenals. With thymosin alpha 1, we've seen people with crazy autoimmune issues just help to stabilize their immune systems, right? And just be able to live a normal life. There's one woman in our community. Unfortunately, she's re-injured herself right now, but she had a spinal leak because of a medical error. And so, so she was essentially horizontal for 2 years. Like she literally couldn't sit up. And it was by using, I think it was GHK and thymosin beta 4, that helped. And the thing is, so here's the thing, right? So there was a medical error made. They used too big a gauge of a needle when they were taking some cerebrospinal fluid to test her for something. What they didn't know is that she had a condition called EDS, which is Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. So her body doesn't make collagen properly. And so that puncture, which shouldn't have been that big in the first place, couldn't heal. And when they tried to patch it, it didn't stick. It was one thing after the other, right? And she was able to restore her mobility and reclaim her life by using GHK and thymosin beta 4, and I think a couple of other peptides.
That's amazing.
Unfortunately, I just heard from her 2 weeks ago. She slipped and fell on the ice. It reopened
Oh
her
no.
leak. And so now
Okay.
she's kind of back to square one again. But this is a person who, unfortunately, the conventional medical world had nothing for her. She actually sits on a board with a bunch of researchers and doctors who specialize in this condition. And I'm like, well, they must be fascinated to hear your story. And they're like, no, they blow me off. They don't want to hear what I have to say. And I'm like, what do you mean? That doesn't make any sense.
Oh, yeah,
So.
that's a common story, which I don't understand. The intellectual curiosity and also the drive to heal. I mean, that should be those two combined. I mean, that's what every doctor should have, right? The drive to heal and some intellectual curiosity.
Well,
I
the
mean,
curiosity is a big one. That's the thing I think that somehow maybe it just gets crushed out of doctors in med school or somewhere along, or they, I think there's some people who are naturally curious and others who aren't. And I think the doctors that are doing the most amazing work in this space are people like you who are just curious and like, well, what do you mean? There's this, what are you talking about? And then tell me more. It doesn't mean you're going to buy into everything, but it's going to lead you down that road of doing your work and your homework and investigating and saying, is there a way for me to apply this with my patients? And as long as it's safe, I'm all in kind of thing.
I love that story. That's amazing. The spinal membrane basically being patched up from
Yeah. Well, it's and so
the
it's giving the body those, it's helping the body to do something. Now
peptides.
we'll see if she's able to fix it. I've got my fingers and toes crossed for her. I really hope that she's able to get back on her feet again. But anyway, so those are a couple of the standout, but we've seen, certainly people with severe gut issues like Crohn's and colitis, again, using the peptides as part of their program. Like they've got to change their diet, they've got to address the microbiome, like they have to do so many things. But though, like just BPC 157 with KPV and lorazepam, like I can put those guys right into remission if they get the right guidance and they're doing the work.